Good morning, everyone. How are you all today? And how are you doing with spelling frame? I can see that lots of you have done lots of spelling activities, so well done. Remember, this week we are doing spelling rule 30 to 35. There's a reminder of the website coming up now. For today's learning, you'll actually need the document you started yesterday, planning speech. Pause now and get that document ready. You also need to make a note of today's date and LI. Today is Wednesday the 24th of June, and the LI is I can punctuate speech. Okay, so what does it mean to punctuate speech? Well, punctuate means to add punctuation. For speech, we use speech marks, and we use a piece of punctuation inside the speech marks that relates to the speech itself. So let's open up our file from Monday and have a look at the success criteria for speech again to make sure we understand how the punctuation is going to work. Okay, so I've got my file open from Monday called Speech. Now let's have a look at the punctuation. Little pig, let me in. So we have the speech marks around the speech, around the words that are said. Roared the big bad wolf in a very loud voice. We also have a piece of punctuation inside the speech marks. Here we have an exclamation mark because this is how they say this piece of speech. Little pig, let me in. The exclamation mark is to signify how shocking and surprising it is. Not by the hairs on our chinny chin chins. Again, we've used an exclamation mark inside speech marks. The punctuation always goes inside. The reason for that is the punctuation is talking about the speech. If it's outside, it's not talking about the speech. Then I'll huff and I'll puff. And we put a comma here because he's not finished talking, has he? Quick, let's run out the back door. They have finished talking, so there's a full stop. And I'll blow your house in. And we end with an exclamation mark here. So, what's our success criteria for punctuating speech today? We need speech marks around the speech, and we need a piece of punctuation inside the speech marks that tells us about the speech. Okay, let's get our planning speech document ready, and we can try and apply our model to our plan. Okay, so I've opened my planning speech file, and we're going to try and apply what we just looked at to our own plan for speech that we wrote yesterday. So I've got my plan here. Good morning, gentlemen and gentlewomen. Can I interest anyone in a magnificent cow? So I'm going to start by putting the speech marks around the speech. There we go. That's obviously what he says. So I put one at the beginning and one at the end. And if you look, we sometimes remember this as 66 and 99, because it looks a little bit like, we zoom right in, we can see these ones point this way, and these ones point this way. So this is what I'd like you to do first. I'd like you to go through your speech plan, and I would like you to add the speech marks to each piece of speech, one at the beginning, and one at the end. Pause now and add your speech marks. Okay, now you've added the speech marks, you should have something that looks a little bit like this. So I've got speech mark at the beginning and speech mark at the end for every piece of speech my characters are doing. So now I need to add the punctuation. Let's start with the first sentence, shall we? Good morning, gentlemen and gentlewomen. Can I interest anyone in a magnificent cow? Well, that's a question, isn't it? So it needs a question mark. Remember, inside or outside? Inside, because this bit inside is a question. The bit outside is not. This young man seems a bit too confident. Full stop. Maybe I can get rid of these useless beans. I think that's a full stop there, because it's a statement. Sorry, I didn't hear you. That's a statement, so that should have a full stop. I was just admiring that truly wonderful cow you have there. That's a statement, so it needs a full stop. Yes, it is a wonderful cow. It won gold in the Cow Olympics and holds the world record for most grass eaten. Now that's a shocking or surprising statement, isn't it? So it needs an exclamation mark. Well, all I can offer is these mystical, magical beans. Statement, so it needs a full stop. What's so special about these beans? And we already put that one in. It's a question, so it needs a question mark. Well, they are the most magical beans in the whole world. I couldn't possibly tell you what they do, but I promise you, you will get endless gold if you plant them in the right spot. Now, I put a full stop there before, but actually, I think that's worth an exclamation mark, don't you? Endless gold? Question mark. You've got a deal. And that's an exclamation mark again, I'd say. Hee hee. I think we should put an exclamation mark there, don't you? Finally, I've got rid of those useless beans, and I've even got myself a cow that can win gold medals. And I've put an exclamation mark there. So your next job is to go to your speech plan, not my one, your one that you did yesterday. And you need to add the punctuation for each piece of speech. And remember, it goes inside the last speech mark. So pause now and add your punctuation inside the speech marks. Okay, so now we've added our punctuation, we've added our speech marks around our speech, and we've added that piece of punctuation inside to show how the speech is said, or to show the type of sentence that the speech is. So, pause now, calm, because our next step tomorrow will be adding in the rest of the sentence that goes after, or sometimes even before the speech. So, well done for today. And have a great day and stay safe.